Hello students, I, Sneha Sharma, your English teacher, welcomes you to your English 2 class. So today we will be starting your third periodic syllabus, that is chapter 10, From a Railway Carriage. So this poem is written by R.L. Stevenson, okay? So let us read this part and then we will move on to the explanation of the poem. When Stevenson wrote this poem, the technology of the railway locomotive was absolutely new. So when this poem was written, the concept of railway trains, it was completely new to that era. Some people even thought that trains or iron horses, they used to refer trains as iron horses, were black magic. So they considered them to be as black magic. Okay. So let us read this part over here. India's first passenger train awaiting departure, it ran between Bombay's Borivandar station and Thane on 16th April 1853. So on 16th April 1853, the first passenger train in India was run between Bombay Borivandar station and Thane. Okay, the scenic Darjeeling Himalayan Railways, this toy trains, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So it is also a part of our heritage and it is one of the important heritages, that the heritage site in the World Heritage Site, okay, given by UNESCO. So this was just the introduction to the chapter. Now let us move on towards the poem. So as I said, this poem is written by R.L. Stevenson. The letter R.L. stands for Robert Louis Stevenson, okay? You can see it's Robert Louis Stevenson. He was born in the year 1850 and died in the year 1894. Was a Scottish novelist, a poet, essayist, musician and travel writer. So he used to write novel, he used to write poems, essays. He was a musician too and he used to write about travels, okay? He is most famous for his stories of adventures like, what are his works? Like Treasure Island, Kidnapped, and Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And his children's poetry collection in A Child's Garden of Verses. So he used to write mostly for children, those poetries. And his collection of poetry is A Child's Garden of Verses. Okay, so this part is also very important, that what are R.L. Stevenson's work? Okay, who is the poet of From a Railway Carriage? So it is R.L. Stevenson. So now we are moving towards the stanza wise explanation of the poem. Okay, you see, faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses and hedges and ditches. So this train is faster than what? Faster than fairies and faster than the witches. Okay, then it goes through the bridges and houses and hedges and ditches. So what are the hedges and ditches over here? Hedge means a row of small bushes or trees growing close together. Okay, so it is the area where trees and bushes grow close together. And ditch, a long narrow hole dug at the side of a field, road, etc. to hold or remove unwanted water. So it is like a hole dug either to store water or to remove extra water. Okay, narrow hole is dug. See, now, and charging along like troops in a battle. So how is the train moving? It is moving like some soldiers are marching in the battlefield. Okay, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle, all of the sides of the hill and plain. So what is happening? The train is running so fast that it is crossing through the meadows, the horses, cattle, the sight of the hill and plain can be seen. Fly as thick as driving rain. So how is the train moving? It is moving very fast, like a driving rain. What is driving rain? Rain that falls very hard and fast. So you see, during a storm, what happened? The rain is absolutely fast and you cannot see the droplets of water. Similarly, the train is also passing very fast. And ever again in the wink of an eye, painted stations whistle by. So the train is so fast that within a wink of an eye, the station looked like something painted and it is just passed away. So the station just in the blink of an eye, the station passes away. And at the station picture is, it looks like something is painted. Okay, you see the train is very fast. It is moving towards the bridges and houses or through the meadows, horses and cattle. Okay, it is moving like as fast as driving rain. Okay, this was for the first stanza. Now moving to the second stanza. So you can see the picture. This also describes a lot about the poem, the train speed. Okay, so let us move on towards this part. Here is a child who clambers and scrambles. So scrambles and scrambles means climbs and crawls, all by himself and gathering brambles. Brambles over here what does it mean? A wild blackberry bush. So what are the children the child is doing? He is climbing those steep hills, and on his way what is he gathering? He's gathering those brambles, those blackberries. Okay, who is carrying those blackberries? That child. Here is a tramp. Tramp over here means someone who has no home or job and moves from place to place, often asking for food or money. Means a homeless person, okay, who doesn't have a home or a job, and he asks for food and shelter from everyone. Okay, so you can see a tramp who stands and gazes. So this homeless person, what does he do? He stands and gazes the train passing by. And there is the green for stringing the daisies. So there is a green valley, green grassland. And there what is happening? The ladies are stringing the daisies. Daisies over here is a white flower with a yellow center. Okay. So this flower has a yellow center and the flower is white in color. Okay. Here is a cart run away in the road, lumping along with man and load. So you can see in the picture, here is a cart. What is that cart is moving very slowly. Okay, and the train is moving very fast and the cart is fully loaded, and you can see the man or the driver, he is sitting on top of the load. And here is a mill and there is a river. So this is a mill, okay, and there is also a river. You see, river. And here is a mill and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone forever. So what happens when the train passes so fast? Those mills, those rivers, everything just passes very fast, so quickly, within a glimpse, okay, within a wink of an eye, everything just passes by. So this was the explanation of the poem. Okay, now I will be discussing the summary of the poem. Okay, I will be dictating it. Okay, I would request you to note it down in your copies if possible. Okay, so here we have the summary of the poem, as well as there is a theme of the poem. So both we are going to discuss in this video. So let us read. The poet describes the sights that he notices while traveling in the train. So what does the poet say? That he notices the sight, whatever the scenery he is seeing when he passes by a train. So the poet is traveling by a train and he is describing his journey through this train. The train is moving faster than fairies and witches, means as more faster than those fairies and witches that train is passing. The train rushes forward like soldiers who are attacking their enemies in the battlefield. So how does the train rushes? It rushes like the soldiers are going to attack their enemy. The speedy movement of the train leaves behind bridges, houses, fences and ditches. Everything is left behind. It also leaves the green fields where horses and cattle are grazing. So the train is moving so fast that the green fields, those horses and cattle that are grazing in that field, passes by within a blink of the moment. Then Stevenson says that all the scenes of the hill and plain were being crossed by the train as quick as one drop of rain following the other in a storm. So in a storm, what happens? Storm in Hindi means tufan. What happens? That when the rain falls very fast, we cannot see those water droplets. Similarly, the train is also passing by. In the next moment, the train passes railway stations and it looked like painted pictures. So when the train passes by those stations, it looks like what? It looks like painted pictures. The poet sees a child climbing a steep ground and collecting berries during his climbing. So you see, as I explained, there is a child who is climbing that steep ground, and on his way, what is he doing? He is collecting berries. He also sees a homeless person who looks at the train with amazement. So that person, that homeless person, that tramp, that person is excited when he sees the train. As the train moves, what happens? Let's see, moves forward. He sees some ladies in a common village grassy land making what? Garlands with daisy flowers. So as I explained, there in the green grassy land, there are daisies and the ladies over there, what are they doing? They are making garlands, means mala. In Hindi, we call it mala, with those daisy flowers. The poet then sees a cart moving slowly in the highway. So you see the cart which is fully loaded. It was full of load and the cart driver was sitting on top of the load. Okay. He also gets a glimpse of a mill and a river by its side. All these objects appeared and disappeared so quickly. So these sights, they appear so quickly while traveling the train and also disappears that quickly when the train passes by. So this was the summary of the poem. Now quickly we will do the theme of the poem. The joy that we get from traveling is the major theme of the poem. Okay, so we all love traveling by train. So this is also the joy of traveling. The theme is the joy, the pleasure that we get when we travel from one place to another. Also, beauty of nature comes as a theme in the description, like meadows, the horses and cattle, sight of the hill and the plain, etc. So it also describes the beauty of nature. The poverty of human beings too is a theme, as suggested by the scene in which a tram looks excitedly at the train. So that poverty, that person is poor, he cannot travel by train. So the excitement that he gets when he sees the train is also the theme of the poem. So this was the summary as well as the theme of the poem. Now quickly we will be discussing the reference to the context of the chapter as well as the question answers. So here I have written it for you, but I'm going to dictate it. All of the sides of the hill and the plain fly as thick as driving rain. So what happens? What are the sights being described? So what are the sights? Sights being described are sights of hill and plain. As you can see, hill and plain is described. Then what are the sights being described as flying? So the sights are being described as flying because the train is moving at a great speed and it seems like flying. So why is the sight being described as flying? Because the train is moving at a great speed and it seems like flying. Okay. Next we have, what is meant by thick as driving rain? So thick as driving rain means rain that falls very hard and fast. So the rain that falls very hard and fast in a storm. Similarly, the train is also described. Okay. So the next stanza. Here is a cart run away in the load, lumping along with man and load. And here is a mill and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone forever. So what do you learn from these lines about the speed of the cart? That the cart is moving very slowly. Okay, the cart is moving very slowly and the train is moving very fast. What might have been the load on the cart? Okay, the load as well as the driver sitting on the load. So both the loads, the load as well as the driver, both are the loads on the cart. Which word here means a quick look? Glimpse. So the word glimpse means a quick look. Okay, so we have discussed the reference to the context. Quickly we will discuss the question answers. What does the poet compare the train to? The poet compared the train to the soldiers attacking their enemies in the battlefield. Okay, so the soldiers are attacking their enemy in the battlefield. Battlefield spelling, I am writing it again. Sorry, the spelling. So here you can see the spelling I have written. The soldiers attacking their enemies in the battlefield. Now describe the images that the poet sees from the window. So this answer is in the first stanza. What does he sees? The bridges, houses, hedges and ditches, the meadows, the horses, cattle, sights of hill and the plain. These are the things that the poet sees from the window. Next, what is the child gathering? So the child is gathering berries, that blackberries, the child is gathering those blackberries. Okay. So now next, what is meant by stringing the daisies? The first part of the question means making garland from daisies. Okay, making garland from daisies. Where are the daisies growing? So the daisies are growing on a village grassy land. So where are they growing? On a village grassy land. Okay, it's grassy land. Next we have, what was the tramp doing when the train passed by? So the tramp was looking excitedly at the train when the train passed by. So he was very excited when the train passed by. So the last question of this chapter is, why does the poet say that station went by in the wink of an eye? So the poet says that the station went by in the wink of an eye because the speed of the train was high and everything appeared and disappeared very quickly. Okay, so this, because of the speed of the train, everything appeared and disappeared very quickly. So this was all for your chapter 10. I would request you to please learn the question answers, go through the word meaning. Okay, that was all for today's class. Thank you.